Damien Four on the Grapevine. We're about to move into a new year. Who better than have a chat about not only wine, but all matters sporting with Matt Skinner from Liquorland. Matt, the year's done. What are you predicting for year 2013?
Sporting-wise, I don't want to moz myself. I really don't want to moz the Hawks, but I'm praying for a Hawks flag this year.
Do you get a little bit superstitious, do you?
Not really, but if they don't win this year now, Terry, I'm going to think it's all my fault. It was back that day when we were filming and, you know, and I said the Hawks. No, look, and I think the other thing I'd love to see, I'd love to see Cadell have a great season and you know, I'd love to see him win another tour. That'd be fantastic.
It's great to see our young sporting stars just sort of hit the horizon and have the opportunity of sort of seeing them sort of when they start their careers and go all the way through.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, look, we've talked about surfing before and we've got, you know, some fantastic young surfers coming through in Australia who will really take over from guys like Mick Fanning and Joel Parkinson in, you know, in coming years. So yeah, it'll be great to watch.
And we're also about to move into 2013. How have you gone with the resolutions? What's the longest you've actually kept one?
Oh, about a week.
What was it?
Drink less.
Well, you are doing the nation a service for Liquorland.
I know.
You are throwing your body head and shoulders into your fine work for Liquorland.
There's been some terrific wines this year. I've got two on the table at the moment. First and foremost, to Henga Sauvignon Blanc out of Marlborough, New Zealand. Fantastic little wine. Really grassy. Got that lovely passion fruit characteristic to it. Clean, crisp, dry. Delicious wine, particularly in warmer weather. We're eating a lot of salads and a lot of grilled seafood and things like that at the moment. Terrific with those kind of things. Now, the other wine that I really love, and I'm passionate about this, is Seppelt Original Sparkling Shiraz. Now, sparkling reds in Australia, they're iconically Australian. The problem is, though, most of us don't know when to consume them. We normally consume them Christmas morning, surrounded in a sea of wrapping paper, you know, as we're unwrapping presents, and it sort of legitimizes having a drink before midday.
Yeah.
And sort of might even numb the onset of the family.
Yeah, it is a bit confronting. So just what is the taste like?
Well, basically what they do here is they take full-bodied Shiraz, in this case out of Great Western, and they then add a little bit of yeast, a little bit of sugar. It then gets re-fermented in the bottle. They'll often add a little bit of vintage port just to sweeten it up at the end. So you get this incredibly sort of dense Aussie Shiraz served cold with bubbles a la champagne or great sparkling wine and a little bit of sweetness as well.
So set the scene for me. When should we drink it?
Do you know, when these wines work so well, not just at Christmas time, but with things like, if you like Peking duck, you know, Peking duck where you've got, you know, that sort of lovely sweetness in the meat, a little bit of fat, hoisin sauce, yes, cucumber, rolled up in a pancake with this, yes, there's nothing better to drink.
It's hard though, and I've taken that particular bottle to certain occasions and no one wants to drink it. I mean, I do, happily, but why is it that, I suppose, the Aussie man doesn't want to drink a sparkling red?
I don't know. And, you know, I think most of us, maybe we associate it with Christmas time and it's something you drink at Christmas time, but most of us just don't know how to drink it. Are we meant to drink it cold? Are we meant to drink it at room temperature? How do you like to drink it?
As cold as you can get it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, fill it right up.
Yeah.
hey, Matt, just while we're talking about Damo going to parties, un-Australianness is when you take half a dozen lights and drink everyone's crownies and you have to get carried out of a party. What is that sort of the un-Australian equivalent of doing that with wine?
Do you know what? Never take a bottle of wine to a party that you really want to drink, because chances are you wander in the front door and the host will exchange that bottle of wine for a lukewarm can of VB and you'll never see a good bottle of wine again.
So let's count them off. Your sporting predictions are Hawthorne to win a flag,
even though
you don't want to say it. Another Australian surfer, male or female, to dominate the scene.
That's right.
And Cadell to get us through those lonely nights in the Pyrenees.
That's it.
With the fizz we've got here.
Absolutely.
Will the sparkling Shiraz still be going while the tour's on in the middle of the year?
Or it probably will be in my place at around about 1 a.m.
Matt Skinner for Liquorland on the Grapevine.